Welcome back to the oneAPI channel. Computer-generated graphics is beautiful, but is also very compute-intensive. Rendering one frame using ray tracing can take many billions of operations. In previous videos, we have introduced Embry, oneAPI ray tracing kernel library that enables real-time ray tracing of scenes constructed by surfaces. But many natural phenomena like smoke and clouds are difficult to model using surfaces. This is why we need the Open VKL, Intel Open Volume Kernel Library. In previous videos, we've talked about the oneAPI components. We mentioned the multi-device, multi-vendor, and open-spec libraries that can now work on multiple devices, CPU, GPU, and others, what we call XPUs, and are arranged into toolkit. One of them is the oneAPI rendering toolkit, which has many components. One of them is Intel Embry to deal with scenes constructed by surfaces. Look for the video on Embry and OpenVKL, the Open Volume Kernel Library. OpenVKL, like Embry, is a high-performance library for ray samplings of scenes. Embry concentrates on computing surfaces samples, and OpenVKL covers volume sampling and efficient traversal of rays through volumes. OpenVKL has a very rich set of volume types, as you can see here. Choose the volume that fits the nature of the object you're modeling, sparse, spherical, particle, or other, and you can apply multiple operations using the C or C++ API on these volume types. Operations that solve common ray volume traversal problems like sampling the volume, computing gradients, and many others. OpenVKL is built for performance, leveraging the latest acceleration like AVX 512, and even though some of the data types are sparse, the operations are optimized for memory consumption and compute. OpenVKL is available on all major operating systems, on Intel CPUs, and soon GPUs. And it's all open source. Maybe the fastest way to get started is by connecting to the Intel Dev Cloud. I'll leave you the link and how to open an interactive VNC session in this video description. Once you have a VNC session on the Dev Cloud, you can navigate to the OpenVKL bin directory, and all the examples are here, ready to run. I'll run the VKL examples, and I will ask for a sphere object, and you can see the sphere here. If you navigate to openvkl.org, I'll leave you the link later, you can see here the API descriptions, what to include, how to initialize, the basic data types, and the volume types supported, adaptive mesh, sparse, VDB, and so on. Under examples, you can find our interactive demo. Click here, and we jump to the GitHub page, interactive, and here is the code. Look for field. You can see here that we can use wavelet, XYZ, or sphere as objects. And we look for sphere. We can see how the object is defined and handled. Now, if I ask for the debug renderer, I can see the full bounding box of the sphere. Look how big it is related to the actual rendering sphere. I can move it around and back to the rendering view, play with the ambient light and other parameters. Pretty cool. And this is a XYZ object. This is how it looks using debug mode. And you can see that the object is sparse. Pretty cool. OpenVKL, volume sampling and traversal kernel library. Enjoy, subscribe, thank you.